Hello all and welcome back to another episode of Making It in Holland. Today I am talking about some typical mistakes that people tend to do when moving to the Netherlands and how to make sure that you are not doing these top three mistakes. The first thing you should avoid at all costs is actually getting a rental property through a Facebook group. I'm quite active in majority of Facebook expat pages and I can see that sometimes the listings that are on there are not 100% proper. Now, if you're desperate and looking for a room or a place to rent, I understand it makes sense to be on Facebook, maybe even on Marktplaats, to look for a rental property, but make sure that the person you're talking to is a legit and that you're not going to get scammed. Especially if someone's profile looks shady and that they don't have a lot of personal information about them and they don't have like a lot of pictures and the profile picture they have is a little bit shady, chances are they're probably out there to get you. And especially if they ask you for money up front, don't give it to them. Don't transfer any money unless there is already a contract in place. The best way to get a rental house here is to go through a rental agency. You might end up paying a little bit more because of their services, but at least you know that you're getting a legit place and that you're not going to get scammed. So next time you're on a Facebook group and you see a listing that feels a little bit too good to be true, you're alert and wise enough not to fall for it. The second thing you should very much pay attention to is getting a Dutch health insurance. Now, I made this mistake when I moved here and I started to work. I had an international insurance and I thought, oh, that's fine. However, about 1 month of me being a full-time employee, I got a letter from the Dutch government asking, where is your Dutch health insurance? And that moment I knew that I should have gotten my insurance a month earlier. So if this is you, if you're coming from overseas and you're not quite sure if your insurance is enough in the Netherlands, make sure to get that checked. But in most cases, you will have to get an insurance here, and it's better to do that sooner. If you have no idea where to look for to choose the insurance policy that is right for you and which company, check out the links in the description below to find one that suits you, your needs, and your budget. Now, on the topic of healthcare, another common mistake I see a lot of people make is not getting familiar with the healthcare system here. Don't get me wrong, there are pros and cons to the healthcare system here, but to make sure to get everything working in your favor, you need to be familiar with the system as soon as possible. So just to break it down for you, there is a monthly premium you pay to an insurance company of your choice. And that premium amount varies depending on the amount of eigen risico, or in English known as personal risk, that you're willing to take. Now, what this means is the higher the premium you pay per month, the lower your eigen risico. So that means if there is an emergency and you have to go to the hospital, there is a lower amount that you have to cover out of pocket before the insurance starts covering the rest of the cost. On the flip side, if you get a lower monthly premium and God forbid there is an emergency and you have to go to the hospital, there is a higher eigen risico amount that you have to pay, which last time I checked was around 800 euros. You have to pay the 800 euros out of pocket before your insurance starts to cover the rest of the expenses. Now, 800 euro might sound like it is a lot, but mind you that healthcare here is quite pricey. So if you end up going to the hospital for whatever reason, trust that the bill is going to be higher than that. And the part that is on top of the 800 is going to be covered by your insurance company. Now, if you're someone who has had chronic illnesses in the past and you need to go to the hospital quite often, I would go for the higher monthly premium so that when you're in the hospital, you're not paying so much out of your own pocket. For example, in Turkey, where I am from, I can just go to a hospital whenever I want to get a consultation with a specialist. In the Netherlands, it doesn't work that way. So first, you need to go to your house doctor. Your house doctor is always your first point of contact. Make sure when you move in that you locate a house arts in your neighborhood and you go talk with him or her. And then you really get familiar with them, because this is the person that you're really depending on to refer you, in the case that you need it, to a specialist at the hospital or in another clinical center. So just to recap everything, first, make sure you get a Dutch insurance policy. Second of all, be very mindful how much money you're paying per month and what is your personal risk. And the third is to be really, really familiar with your house doctor. The last thing I want to mention as part of this video is to learn Dutch before actually moving here. Now, you might be thinking, I'm going to have plenty of time when I move to the Netherlands. I'm going to be with Dutch people, so I can actually learn the language much faster. I guarantee you, when you do move here, other things are going to take priority, making it more and more difficult for you to actually learn the language, which is very important to do as early on as possible. If you've seen some of my other videos, you know that I say everybody here pretty much speaks English, but that is in no way a replacement of learning Dutch. Because when you learn Dutch alongside a good handle of English, you're actually a more valued member of the society here, especially when it comes to looking for jobs. Not many people talk about this, but it is indeed very true that the moment you make an application and you don't have Dutch written in your CV, the chances of you getting the job actually decreases by quite a lot. So keep that in mind to learn the language before coming here, and when you do, your integration to the culture here will be a lot easier as well. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this week's episode. If you have any other questions about life in the Netherlands, make sure to check out some of the videos that will be appearing on your screen right now. And as usual, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And as usual, until the next episode, don't forget to stay awesome. Bye bye.